Paris on Monday, and then we did Berlin, and now we're here in London, and it's going great. Yeah, it's a very exciting thing.
Can't wait for it to come out. I mean, as Tim said in the last interview, we feel like since we've been around the music so much, it's odd that it isn't out yet.
Yeah,
have you heard? Oh yeah, that's right. It's not coming out until January.
Yeah, right.
Put it out.
But yeah, it's great. But that's typically the way it goes, just because of all the run-up with promo and everything like that. Yeah. Usually, we've listened to the album about 50 times before we say, I never want to hear that again.
Yeah.
And then it's another 2 months before it comes out for everybody else.
Exactly.
The idea was just to sort of get to a place where there weren't any distractions or anything like that. As much as we love recording at home, we're still at home. You still have a foot in both worlds. You know, you still are trying to make it home for dinner to please the family and everything like that, but then you still want to get all your work done. So this was a scenario where we could just go. We lived, we all slept in rooms that were probably about 100 steps from the studio, and we just, you know, ate, drank, slept the new songs.
Yeah, I mean, you're like steeped in it, you know what I mean? And there's no interruptions except, I mean, you know, just, I mean, to have a meal, to get some rest, but you're never leaving that creative womb that you've created there, that we
created. Yeah, you're still, like, even when we would leave to go to lunch or something, we would all be sitting at the table eating lunch together, talking about
what we had just done,
yeah. What we were about to do. It was awesome.
It made it a great record. I mean, I think, when we sit back and see what we've, 20 years into this, to be able to still find gold in the mine, and I feel like we have with this record, you know what I mean? It's like, that says something about a band. I mean, we're really excited, because I think it's a daunting thing. As exciting and as cool it is to say, oh, we've been a band for 20 years, it also becomes then a challenge to not do the same thing over and over again. You know, there's a few bands that can get away with that, the Ramones, you know what I mean? Like, they were the masters of that, and everybody loves the Ramones, but we're, you know, and we've always kind of considered ourselves the Ramones of what we do, in the sense that Dropkick, you're going to get, you know, your punk and your Irish, but, you know, this is a genre that I feel like this band created, the Celtic punk, you know what I mean? When I joined this band 18 years ago, there was no such genre. You know, there were the Pogues, and then there was the Dropkick Murphys, you know what I mean? And, you know, there's been a flood of bands afterwards now, and I'm sure there's bands out there that are going to hear this and go, oh, no, dude, there's this other band. But guess what? If there's a tree in the woods and it falls and no one's there to hear it, does it make a noise? Well, this tree fell and it made some noise.
It's still pretty similar to how it's been for a while. I mean, the difference now is that I think they're starting to put a little bit more money into it, you know, just like a lot of other places. They're going to the neighborhoods that people are saying, that's not a very good neighborhood, and they're going, condos, this, we're gonna make this a good one, so there's,
yeah,
like
the customs guy was going on about that, yeah, when we landed yesterday.
There's some gentrification going on and stuff like that, and it's funny because you get the people who are willing to pay so much money for a crazy apartment and
or next, a parking space.
Yeah,
or,
and the next door is a guy that's lived there his entire life who's like a total townie. You know, so it's the coexisting of these two sort of different dichotomies, but you know, for us, Boston has always remained just sort of a source of inspiration, in the fact that the way that the people are, the way that we were brought up, just the New England area in general, like, you know, we're all just really blue collar, working class guys from the area, with a slight chip on our shoulder because we were born in New England.
Yeah.
It bleeds in the songwriting in the sense that you know, when we talk about growing up and where we come from and make reference to Boston Place and stuff like that, we're talking about this place that we love so much and that we spent so much time in, and that has sort of, you know, you get your identity sometimes. A lot of your identity is about where you're from and who your friends are, and your family and all sorts of things. I think just sort of the both the work ethic and the sort of loyalty ethic that exists in the Northeast is something that we're very proud of.
The work ethic in New England is definitely an anomaly. It's funny, I had a friend years ago, move out to Petaluma, California. And 7 months into his job, the old guy said, "I can't believe you're still here." And he was like, my buddy Trevor was like, "What do you mean?" He goes, "I must have had 20 kids your age come through here and work maybe a month and then they'd quit. And you've been here 7 months." And he ended up working there for 7 years. And, but they weren't used to someone from New England who, you know what I mean, just stuck at it, you know what I mean? And that's kind of the New England way, you know what I mean? The winners make us, I think the winners give us that chip on their shoulder that Tim's talking about, you know what I mean? And, but it makes us also hardy, hardy folk. And, you know, yeah, I think we're getting ready for another big winner too.
People are going to be hearing a lot of new songs for the first time, and we're going to be playing a lot of new songs for the first time.
Yep.
And that'll be exciting. It's always fun to add new stuff to the repertoire, especially at this point where our last record came out 4 years ago, something like that. So it's time for some new blood in the set list.
Pun intended.
No pun intended. Because there's a song called Blood. We just seem to keep doing what we do, and you know, we're gonna, the live show I think is a really important part of our band, and we're always trying to come up with ways to make it more exciting and everything, and that's just what we're gonna keep on doing.
Yeah, our mindset is when we get on stage, we're going into battle. And you know, we want to, we're just, you know, attack, you know what I mean? And our audience is, you know, I mean, they're as intricate to the concert as we are. We feel it's that relationship we have together that makes the experience of a Dropkick Murphys concert what it is.
Yeah.
And without them, we're nothing.
I mean, playing is obviously why we're there, you know. Those I mean, sometimes you get to see some friends you haven't seen in a while, and but I mean the reason that we're there is to,
that
is
90
to play
minutes
shows,
on stage, you know, every night.
Yeah. You'd be surprised at how little I can accomplish during the day when I have to have to put all my energy into a 90-minute set. I think we're gonna come back and do a lot more.
You'll be tired of us by the end of 2017.
Yeah.
Believe me, we'll be coming back.
It's a combination of what we do and what the fans do. Really, we like Al said, we wouldn't be able to do it without them, to the point where our last few songs, without everybody on stage, we found are incredibly boring sometimes.
Yeah. Yeah.
So we invite everybody up on the stage at the end to hang with us and party with us and everything, and to enjoy the last few songs. And we just look to give people a great time, you know. We're all very aware that, especially in times like these with shitty economies and stuff like that, when people come to a show, it doesn't matter that we're playing 30 shows that tour. For those people, that we're doing one show.
All that matters is that night.
So we don't want those people to be like, "Yeah, I saw them, they were kind of tired." You know, like, you don't want that.
We want them to, we want to see, and that's, I mean, that's, I guess, one of the positive things of social media is you can get that instant feedback.
Yeah.
After you play a show, and you can look at the feedback and you can see. And that's why, And the other thing that we do is we change the set a lot. You know, we have kind of, you know, songs that are going to be foundation songs that you're going to find throughout the set that we'll always play, because they're such favorites amongst the fans. But then we're going to say, you know, when you've got you know, this is our ninth studio album. So when you've got eight, you know, albums in your quiver, you know what I mean? You have, you know, so it isn't you know, we sound check every day. And it's all of us on there, you know what I mean? And you know, we'll pull out pages of old songs and we'll go, "Well, we had a request for this song that was written in 1997 and we haven't played it since 1999. And you know, and so then we go, "We gotta learn it." And
yeah.
So then we'll learn that song and we will play that song that night. And that's how much that's how much the fans mean to us. It's like, you know, I mean, we can't do that every time. We can't always do that. But we find that the fans really appreciate it, and you see them communicating to each other, like, what did they do? You know, what was the set list? It's like, well, it was totally different than it was here, and that's, and then people, you see people really appreciate that, because, you know, what really freaks us out is there's some people that just follow us. And so if we were to play the same songs every night, and it's like, those five people were there last night and the night before and the night before, and here we go playing this song again, and you almost feel like all of a sudden you haven't left, when actually you've gone six different countries or states or whatever, you know what I mean? So we change it up to keep it interesting for ourselves and for the fans.